How to add tags in Adobe Premiere Pro CC 2020. Today, I want to show you how to create awesome tags animations inside of a Premiere Pro by using Essential Graphics Panel and save as a motion graphic templates. Let's get started. Select the graphic workspace from the top of the screen or go to Windows Workspaces and select Graphics and Essential Graphics. Let's create text layer. Go to Toolbar and select Type Tool and click on the Program Monitor to create title. You can adjust the appearance of the text using the Edit tab of the Essential Graphics panel. You can align and transform the text. Click Align button to center your title in the Program Monitor. Let's create new text layer from the Edit tab. Click New Layer and create text layer. You can change the duration of the graphic layer. You can change the opacity of the text, scale, position, fonts, and more. You can change the color of the text, text styles, change the background of the text, strokes, and shadows. Let's animate this text layer. Animate this text layer using Essential Graphics panel. Select Toggle Animation of Scale and increase the size of the title and you will see keyframe is generated in the Effects Control panel. Move the playhead and adjust the scale value 100 in the Essential Graphics panel to record the keyframes. Hit Enter or Return on a Mac to render animation. Let's create another title animation. I'm going to create a background layer and apply gradient fill. Select Rectangle tool from the tool panel and create background. Rename the shape layer and change the color and apply gradient. Select linear or radial gradient. Draw vertical line. Change the color of the line to purple. And position the anchor point into the center of the line. So align this layer into the center of the screen. Now let's animate this line. Go to Effects Control panel, locate the shape layer and toggle the scale animation for this line. Uncheck the uniform scale, click stopwatch icon and set vertical scale value to 0 to disappear this line and add keyframe. Move playhead to scale in to reveal this line. Select the keyframes and right click Easy In to enable interpolation to make smooth animation. You can see this small graph. We grab these handles to manually adjust the rate of the speed. We grab the handles down to make smooth and easy in. After that, we select the rotation and add keyframes and move playhead to add keyframe value 90 degrees to rotate line. Now create a text layer and animate the position of the text. Select the text layer and move the text layer off the screen from the right side and set keyframe. Move playhead and add keyframe. The position of the text where the rotation of the line end. Another text layer, subtitle layer. Set position vertically downside. And add keyframes and move playhead and set position of the keyframe just after the main title. Hit enter or return to render the animation. Your intro animation is created.
Let's create outro animation for the start of. Select the subtitle and add position keyframe and move playhead and change the position of the text horizontally right side of the screen to disappear the text. Select the main title and locate the position in the effects control panel and add keyframes, move playhead and move the position of the text horizontally left side of the screen. Select shape layer, set keyframes and move playhead and put scale value to 0 to disappear this line to end up the outro animation. Let's create another title animation. Create a vertical line in the center of the program monitor and drag the anchor point to the center of the line. Rename the shape layer. Go to effects control panel and locate shape or line layer and select scale parameter and uncheck the uniform scale property. Set vertical scale to 0 to fade out or disappear line from the start. Move the playhead and add keyframes to scale out this line or to reveal this line. Apply temporal interpolation on both keyframes to ease in and to make a smooth animation. Drag that handles from velocity graph to make awesome and better animation. Let's create a text layer and how to reveal this text by using mask. So create a text layer and position it into the center and apply mask. Increase the mask size. I want to reveal the stacks from a line to popping up after the visibility of the line. Let's add keyframes. I'm going to add keyframes for position under the transform property. Move text horizontally left side to make it invisible and pop up after the line animation. Move playhead and add keyframe to position in or reveal this stacks. To make it move smoother, select easy in from interpolation settings, drag the handles of the keyframes and render it. Let's create a second subtitle layer and select the background to red. Apply mask on this layer and reveal this layer from the center of the line. Select position and add keyframes. And move text right side to make it invisible and move playhead after a couple of frames to pop up this text and position a keyframe to reveal this text.
Select Easy In to make it smoother. This is the simple intro animation. Let's make outro animation. To preserve animation intro and outro, define the segment of intro of the clip layer. Just chop off the effects control panel, select blue handles, drag the left handle to define intro, and you will see this gray overlay that covered the intro keyframes, and it preserved the intro animation. Now let's create outro animations to end up the title animation. Reverse all the procedure to reveal out the title. To preserve outro animation, select blue line from the top and drag it to right side. Select graphic layer and right click to export this title animation as a motion graphic templates for your future use. In Adobe Premiere Pro CC 2020, new underline text style button is available in Essential Graphics panel. Let's animate the text like typewriter. Create text layer and select new underline text style button from Essential Graphics panel. Go to Effects Control panel and select Source Text and click Stopwatch to add keyframe. Move playhead and type letter one by one.
and now render it. In this way, you will create a typewriter animation very easiest way. New multi-line text fields options inside of a Premiere Pro CC 2020. Motion graphic templates, which is created in After Effects, has now option to include multi-line text fields. We can add and edit multiple lines of text in Premiere Pro CC 2020. In Premiere Pro CC 2020, we can convert text or shape to mask layer. We place video inside of our text by using mask with text option in the edit tab of Essential Graphics panel. Go to File, select New Layer of Video, Import File, and check the option Mask with Text. Now guys, this is all about the text and titled animation inside of a Premiere Pro CC 2020. I hope you like this video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video. Thanks for watching Digital Creations.